was sticking to my shoes. Now I look out my front porch at this panoramic view. I can sit and watch the fields fill up with rays of golden sun, or watch the moon lay on the fences like that's where it was hung. My blessings aren't in front of me, it's not about the land. I'll never beat the view from my front porch looking in. There's a carrot top that can barely walk with a sippy cup of milk. A little blue-eyed blonde with shoes on wrong, cause she likes to dress herself. And the most beautiful girl holding both of them. Yeah, the view I love the most is my front porch looking in. Traveled here and everywhere, following my job. I've seen the paintings from the air brushed by the hand of God. The mountains and the canyons reach from sea to shining sea. But I can't wait to get back home to the one he made for me. Cause anywhere I'll ever go and everywhere I've been, nothing takes my breath away like my front porch looking in. There's a carrot top that can barely walk with a sippy cup of milk. A little blue-eyed blonde with shoes on wrong, cause she likes to dress herself. And the most beautiful
The union of Andrew and Lindsay brings together two family traditions, two systems of roots in the hope that a new family tree may become strong and sweet. Theirs is a personal choice for which they are primarily responsible. However, their life will be enriched by the support of the families from which each has come. So John and Pat, I ask you stand here with Lindsay to symbolize the traditions and family from which she comes.
We do.
And Alucio and Marcy, do you stand here with Andrew to symbolize the traditions and family from which he comes?
We do.
Now to both of you sets of parents, I ask, do you encourage Andrew and Lindsay in their marriage? Do you promise to encourage them?
We will.
We will.
Do you celebrate with them the decision they've made in choosing each other?
We do.
And finally, now listen carefully to this one. Will you continue to stand beside them yet not between them?
We will.
Well spoken. Thank you very much. You may all be seated. Today we have gathered at the request of Lindsay and Andrew as they take each other's hand in marriage. It is fitting and appropriate that you, their friends and family, be here to witness and participate in their wedding. Because the ideals, the understanding, and the mutual respect they bring to their marriage have their roots in the love, friendship, and guidance that you have poured into them over the years. Gathered here today, we constitute an incredibly unique and diverse community. However, there's one single thread that runs through our relationship with Lindsay and Andrew. And that is that each one of us holds a special place in Lindsay and Andrew's heart. For this reason, they've chosen to ask each of you here to share in this joyous occasion. And to their delight, you've accepted their offer to celebrate with them here this evening. Each of you have made sacrifices in order to support and participate in Lindsay and Andrew's lives, including, for many of you, just traveling to be here to be a part of this celebration today. And you need to know that Lindsay and Andrew will always be so grateful for your participation and the sacrifices you have made. Now, during this ceremony, Lindsay and Andrew will be exchanging rings. The rings that they will be exchanging are a visible sign of the commitment they are going to be making to one another. As this ceremony proceeds, we're going to invite all of you gathered here today as family and friends to take part in what we call the warming of the rings. We ask that as the ring is passed to you, you can hold that for a moment and wish them health and happiness and all that is noble in life. As you hold it and warm it with your love and make a silent wish for this couple and their future together, then pass the ring on to the person next to you. We'll begin the passing of the rings. They're tied carefully together here. And we're going to begin with Lindsay's mother. You'll hand that to Lindsay's mother. And then as you'll pass them back to the back, and the person on the aisle and back has the task of carrying it across the aisle, and then pass it forward until it comes back to Andrew's mother, from which we hope we'll be able to retrieve it when the time comes. I now want to invite our matron of honor, Sarah, to share our first reading with us. Simple title, Love.
Love is a friendship that has caught fire. It is quiet understanding, mutual confidence, sharing, and forgiving. It is loyalty through good and bad. It settles for less than perfection and makes allowances for human weakness. Love is content with the present. It hopes for the future, and it doesn't brood over the past. It's the day in and day out chronicle of irritations, problems, compromises, small disappointments, big victories, and working toward common goals. If you have love in your life, it can make up for a great many things you lack. If you don't have it, no matter what else there is, it is not enough. So search for it, ask God for it, and share it.
Thank you so much, Sarah. Lindsay and Andrew, I believe that all of your guests here this evening agree that the two of you indeed do have that kind of love in your life that Sarah was just describing. In fact, it's kind of a unique love that has developed between the two of you over the last 5 years. But just as Sarah shared with us in the reading, it was, first of all, a friendship, and then it caught fire. Now, I want to spend a few moments determining how this friendship began and when, where, and how it caught fire. Lindsay, when you first met this guy back in 2005, you were part of a group that was interviewing him for a job. I don't know if any of the folks know it, but you weren't that impressed at first.
Is that true?
In fact, if we use the same terminology as that reading, we'd probably have to say it was going to take a huge amount of lighter fluid to get the thing going. Andrew, that day as you gazed upon this woman, you were intrigued by her striking appearance and the presence that she had in that room. You knew that you needed to get to know her better. However, Lindsay, as we mentioned, you weren't impressed. This new guy seemed arrogant, not very personable, but yet the group was told they had to hire him whether you liked him or not, and so you were part of hiring this guy. Little did you realize what it was you were hiring, huh? As you got to know him better in a lab, you felt there's a little rudeness about him, but over time it became less offensive. And somehow you were able to overcome that and become friends. A few months later, in 2006, you finally had what you both describe as your first date. Now, Lindsay, your first date was hanging out after work, after those long Tuesdays, over at Dogfish Head Ale House. There you would drink and talk and talk and drink. And the first time you went over there, Andrew talked the whole time. But the following week, you took charge and you talked the entire time. Then the first, Lindsay, official date for you was going to breakfast up in Harrisburg, where you met some of his friends, and he referred to you as his girlfriend, which was kind of nice for you to hear. Now, Andrew, you remember things slightly differently. For you, the first date was when you were out on a work function bowling in Chinatown down in D.C., and as the evening was winding down, the two of you decided to... The two of you decided to stay out longer and managed to find your way over to Bistro Dupont, a French restaurant in Dupont Circle. And after too much wine, you managed to find the metro station and somehow get back up to Maryland. At least you both had first dates with each other. Just now, through the years, there have been special people in your lives who have encouraged the relationship. Lindsay, you said that when your mom and sister first met Andrew early on, they immediately liked him. And it's a good thing their first impression is different than yours. About 6 months into dating, Andrew, you met Lindsay over in Amsterdam to celebrate her birthday and kind of started a tradition that's become a really fun and much anticipated annual event, because we know that Lindsay will continue to have birthdays and you'll continue to go to fun places to celebrate. Now, you've also continued hanging out at your favorite hangout, Dogfish Head Ale House. It's become your place for drinks and conversation and just having fun. And so the relationship built over the years, and finally in June of 2008, Andrew, you were anticipating a lot of upcoming travel. And you wanted Lindsay to know before all of that that you were committed to the relationship and that the absence was only going to be temporary, that you really were going to be back together soon. And so sitting casually on the floor of your living room, somewhat uncharacteristic because you're the kind of guy that likes to make big events happen, you pulled out the ring box and simply asked Lindsay if she'd become your wife. Lindsay, you were expecting some grand celebration.
Surprise.
This was simple, straightforward. And Lindsay, your reply was also simple and straightforward. And so that brings you standing right here this evening, almost 2 years after the engagement. As you stand here ready to share your vows of commitment, I want to share with your guests some of your thoughts that you put down on paper and shared with me. Andrew, you said, as I think about the commitment we're about to make, I feel nothing short of excitement, looking forward to what the two of us can do more fully together, starting a new phase of our lives together, beginning with the wedding, starting a family, changing careers, locations. We're ready for anything together. Well, Lindsay, here's what you said. I'm excited to get married. Andrew and I have been together for over 4 years. We know each other well. We work well together. And I like it that you were very, very real. You said, that doesn't mean we always get along. But we always work things out. That's the important thing. We're both ready to start a family, to see marriage as moving one step closer to building our own family and traditions. And so we go back to that theme that Sarah set up for us. Who'd figure that we'd be talking about love at a wedding? In your case, it was a friendship, finally, that caught fire and continues to this very day to burn deeply in your hearts for each other. And so I'm so proud of the fact that you both took the time to write your own personal vows, which I believe has really come from your heart. Andrew, I'd like to invite you to share your vows first with Lindsay and look deeply into her eyes.
Lindsay, my love, today I become your husband and you my wife. As you will denote, define, and will be my life, and with you, I become your wife. You compel me to love, to believe, to hope, and to embrace the future. With you, every day will be a new moment of wonder, together, ready at every turn for what life has in store for us. I promise to love you, support you, and always be by your side. Lindsay, my love, today we start our new lives together. I love you.
I want to invite Mark, our best man, to share our reading with us, which is a blessing for marriage.
May your marriage bring you all the exquisite excitements a marriage should bring, and may life grant you also patience, tolerance, and understanding. May you always need one another, not so much to fill your emptiness as to help you know your fullness. May you need one another, but not out of weakness. May you want one another, but not out of lack. May you entice one another, but not compel one another. May you embrace one another, but not encircle one another. May you succeed in all important ways with one another and not fail in the little graces. May you look for things to praise, often say I love you, and take no notice of small faults. May you have happiness, and may you find it making one another happy. May you have love, and may you find it loving.
Mark? Now, Lindsay and Andrew, inasmuch as you each have expressed your desire to become one in marriage, you've each shared your vows. Now it's time for us to retrieve the rings and invite you to please share these rings with one another. Now the rings that I hold before you that every one of you have warmed with your love and your own hands are very, very special. It's much more now than just precious metal. It's precious metal that is filled with the love and support of your friends and family here today. These rings will always be to you a visible sign of the inward and invisible grace that you feel towards each other with the love that you have deep in your hearts. In the years ahead, as you look to this precious metal turning upon itself, may it always remind you of the unending and enduring quality of the promises you both have made in the vows that you wrote. So, Lindsay, I invite you to place this ring on Andrew's finger. Repeat after me. Andrew, I give you this ring as a sign of my love and faithfulness. Andrew, as you place this ring on Lindsay's finger, please repeat after me. Lindsay, I give you this ring.
Lindsay, I give you this ring. Lindsay, I give you this ring.
As a sign of my love and faithfulness.
As a sign of my love and faithfulness.
Well, now you've given the ring. You've symbolized, the ring symbolizes the vows that you've exchanged. So now it's my privilege by the power vested in me by the state of Maryland to declare that you indeed are husband and wife, finally. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my privilege to introduce to you the newly married couple. It's Mark and Lindsay. Let's hear it for them. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Andrew and Lindsay here.
Just a quick toast while we get started. The champagne's still cold. It's got the gas in it. Might as well enjoy it. This is just a simple thank you to a number of folks that are here. Firstly, my wife, Lindsay. And damn, that feels good to say. Sweetheart to you. To John and Pat Wazor, helping make this possible. Yeah. To all of our family and friends, to coming here. We knew that most of you were traveling a damn long way to be here, cross countries, cross oceans, cross states. Long way. So it means a lot to us, to all of you, to help making this a memorable night. Thank you so much. And please enjoy the champagne, and let's have our first toast of the night. Cheers.
For the first time as husband and wife, I'd like to call Andrew and Lindsay out on the floor for their first dance. The competitions to see who could do more shots of espresso in a single sitting. And you both got to about 30 at our top match and cut it off there. There was the road trips where we searched. We went out of our way like tens of miles to find the gas station with the good French vanilla cappuccino.
In the U.S.
I think we drove like 50 miles out of our way in Nebraska to find the one place open at 2 in the morning that had French vanilla cappuccino. Which made me think our relationship is largely built on caffeine, as much as alcohol, right here in Wisconsin. But so I was thinking about these stories and how I could sum up how I feel about Lindsay, and the one that actually popped in my head is I actually got hospitalized, I think it was my sophomore year in college, and Lindsay, being who she was, you know, I was basically laying in a hospital bed, sort of writhing around in pain, and Lindsay came in and making me feel better, you know, would constantly untie my gown, or lift up my gown, right, as, like, different people walked by in the hallway, or do all those sorts of things. But that really, I think, does sum up, you know, Lindsay. I mean, she really is, I mean, she makes, she doesn't even try, but she makes everyone around her happier.
I always feel bad when we're together and people are like, oh, so what do you do? And I'm like, oh, you know, I do IT at a law firm. What does she do? She cures AIDS. I'm like, yeah, I don't know if those measure up. But I mean, really, with everything she's done. And the first time I met Andrew was actually at our house. They drove out a couple years ago. And knew Andrew was good right away. I never had to give Andrew a talk that I had given to several other and I don't think I did. Did I? I didn't threaten you, did I?
One sentence, maybe.
Maybe one sentence saying I'm not going to threaten you because you
seem won't die tonight.
No guns, no guns or anything. But he was actually, he was great. He was playing with the kids the whole time. He still gets, Uncle Andrew has the white stripe, right? Yes. And so, I mean, Andrew was just sort of great from the beginning. And but Lindsay really, I mean, she's a great listener. She makes everyone around her better for being around her. She's my best friend. I love you dearly. I'm very happy that you found Andrew because I see how happy he makes you. And I just hope you guys have a long and happy marriage. And just wish you much happiness. So, cheers. Cheers.
Finally, I wrote up this limerick, which just came very naturally, and here's the limerick. Dearest Andrew and Lindsay, so glad you've taken the test. What else shall one really say but wish you the very best? The search is finally over, no loneliness, no beer guzzling nights, Lindsay.
Damn it.
Of all your precious time, cats, babies, walking the dogs will take the greater bite. Aloysio couldn't be happier. A grandpa he wants to be. Marcy, a grandmother, and Carla, the aunt to be. So much is expected of you, but mostly little thoughts. Made in the lab,
no pressure,
or in the bed, no matter, of them, they want a lot.
Get out of here, man. Get out of town. Get out of town.